Hey guys, so I'm currently, a graduate student majoring in social work, and I'm also an intern at a public high school, working with social workers and providing emotional and social support to students who go there, who are pretty much ninth graders. It's a brand new school, so they only have a ninth grade class. That's what I do. Another thing I'm doing is also my part-time job is being a classroom tutor in local. It's like 10 minute walk from where I'm living, so it's very local to me. Local public elementary school. I'm a classroom tutor there. I'm in a science classroom working with an pretty much under a science teacher, and kind of just helping her with whatever she needs help with, and also helping the students learn in the classroom. And I actually really like being a classroom tutor. It's a very fun job for me. Sometimes I forget that I'm there as a, it's my job that I'm being paid for. It's just I really enjoy being there, and I have a lot of fun just helping these kids learn, I guess, and just talking with them. And it's easy. The kids I meet are pre-kindergartners, kindergartners, first graders, third graders. I haven't worked with the second grader. I don't think the second grade class for some reason has the science teacher ever. So I don't know why, but that's just how it is. And then I work with also fourth graders, and then there's a fifth grade special education class that comes in. And I can come in. I don't even have to really study the lesson plan or anything, and I can help them because the materials they're learning is like it's really easy to me. For a lot of them, it can be hard. Really, it was really difficult for a lot of the students to get the concept of making a line graph, for example. And they were really struggling with that, which was, I look at some of the things that these students are doing and I'm helping them. I just realize, like, wow, like, I think back to the days when I was an elementary school student, and it's just like, it must have been challenging to me as well. It definitely must have been. It was. I can't really remember when I was an elementary school student and when I was learning, but it definitely must have had an accumulative effect, because now I can do those things without any problem, Line graphs, doing the scientific experimentation, the hypotheses and testing, evaluation, conclusion, doing logbooks and all these kind of things, not a problem. And so I think schooling has had a big impact, even though we may not even realize how big of an impact they are. But you grow up, you be, you know, be try tutoring, and you'll just realize how your knowledge base is. I generally really like the job, but there is one unsettling thing to me when I'm in that environment. When I'm in the, especially the, not so much in like a high school. I'm not sure about middle school, but elementary school. It's definitely like it bothers me a little bit that the there's such discouragement of kids talking, or of kids being able to act a bit freely, I guess it's understandable, in order to teach a class, a big group of students something, you need them to be quiet and orderly and respectful and all that. But it just kind of distracts me when, if they're not looking at the teacher, if they're looking the other way, if they're looking at the ground, they're kind of yelled at to be like, or looked at like with an expression like, come on, like you have to be paying attention. I'm gonna take your recess away. That's also like one of the threats, One of the threats that a teacher might use is, you guys are not behaving. I'm gonna treat you like how I treat my kindergarten class. You guys are not. I'm gonna take your recess away. And I'm not against that kind of a consequence. I'm not against using negative consequences to reinforce certain kind of behavior in a school setting for kindergarten, for that lower grade students, for kids, for children. I'm not totally against it, but it the question is, why would they be punished? Well, because one of the students there was talking or chatting with this other student that was sitting next to him, or he was standing up and down a lot. Certainly these can be distracting to other students who are trying to learn, but it's just what I notice in just this one elementary school. I haven't been to a lot of elementary schools, so I can't really make a, you know, this is not a research opinion. This is just my personal opinion from what I've seen so far. There seems to be a culture of silencing our kids in schools. And that seems really negative. Like I said, I understand the reasons that are there for that. Is to make sure that the kids learn as quickly as possible, and they have to learn, you know? And it will help them in the long run. But it's, I don't know, it could be the teaching methods of the teachers that I see, but a lot of teachers I see do generally get, they look really angry, and they get to a yelling stage where, you know, kids are talking, and so much of, like, this habitual thing is focused on making sure the kids are quiet. You know, we have the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and the kids have to repeat 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and everyone quiet. Put a bubble gum in your mouth, and, or no, put a marshmallow in your mouth and hold it there. Put your head down, and stay quiet. You know, there's a lot of these, like, instructions in which kids are discouraged to speak. And in fact, you know, there's encouragement of, you know, you have to raise your hands to speak. Which, like I said, I understand all the reasons for it, but just the way that it's enforced, it kind of unsettles me. And I guess, especially as a social work student, you know, my internship, I'm doing group therapy work. You know, I get students in a group setting, and it's kind of frustrating that the biggest challenge that I have is making this environment as comfortable for them to just kind of just share their thoughts aloud, be free to talk their mind, and be free to collaborate with each other. It's challenging because they don't want to speak, they don't want to collaborate. And why are they like this? Well, because this culture that they have been receiving ever since they were little kids, that they were rewarded for being kind of introverted, and they were rewarded for being quiet and not being aggressive or whatever. In one of my classes, in college class, this is a human behavior class, we were talking about social learning theory, and how in that theory there is the concept of the difficult child and the easygoing child. And this adjective, I think, is really important. When we conjure up the mind of a difficult child, well, difficult in regards to what or who, it's difficult to the parent, right, or the caretaker or the teacher. But the difficult child, it's important for a child to be a difficult child. We value a child being easy, but, you know, if you put them in a survival setting, let's say that there's a group of five difficult children designated, and five easy children. And maybe they grow up in this island. they're forced into this island, right? And they're like, okay, survive. Who's most likely to survive? Well, studies actually have shown that it's the difficult children who will end up surviving, and the easy children who will end up dying, pretty much, or not surviving. Why is that? Well, the reason is because difficult children will, you know, it is kind of like they assert their authority. You know, they know what they want, and they will go and get it. Whereas easy children have been conditioned to kind of always look for guidance or for dependence. So by the time they're asking for permission, like, hey, there's that apple on the ground. You know, is it okay if I take it? By the time he's asking that, the difficult child has already taken it and is eating it. You know, that's why he's surviving. So you know, I think as a educational culture, or at least as in this elementary school that I'm in, the culture is to really just kind of, you know, make the kids as compliant, as conformative as possible. And it's unsettling to me because it's not optimal. I mean, I guess to work in society and be accepted in society is important. But it should be encouraged, but the attitude that we have towards these children, I think, is also very important. And if we have a culture where we're, you know, kind of really enforcing in that manner, like silencing our kids, that can be really problematic as well.